Here comes the mailman.
Jesus Christ.
All right, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to the video. And today, guys, we have, well, quite a large eBay haul. Pretty much, I was away for half of August. And over that time, I got a lot of eBay packages. Lots and lots of trucks. Over 50. And actually, the final truck just came today, and you can really tell how UPS handles their packages. So yeah, I know what truck this is. See it in a minute. I was really happy to get this for such a good price. And from the looks of it, it's in really good condition. But this, the way USPS handled it, it's getting me a bit concerned. I hope they didn't screw it up. Anyway. Alright. More packing peanuts. Great. And he said, thank you so much for the harvest. More diecast this week. Yeah, what a nice guy. I'll take this off so that I remember his account. Wow. I can see it from here. White rims. Any guesses so far? This is a 2007 truck. Let me just slip the bubble wrap. There we go. I put it in a Ziploc bag. Wow, this truck is so mint. It's awesome. The Destroyer from 2007. This is just the normal version. Wow. Pictures actually showed how good it was. This truck is so clean. It's like he just took it out of the packaging. Wow. Such an awesome truck. I needed one of these versions of the Destroyer. I still need like the X-Ray Sir, the Small Hub Edition. So that's that. I'll get into the other trucks now. Well over 50. I'm kind of going to speed run through them so I don't go over 15 minutes for stupid iMovie. I'll start off with the trucks I got well over a month ago. So I got my first ever plastic base Eradicator. Really cool. I've been stuck with the Small Hub SUV version for a while because that was my first ever truck. We got Gold Machines Hot Wheels, my first ever one. Got this for just $10 and free shipping. Really can't pass that up. What else we got? I'm not a playset exclusive truck guy, but when I come across them for a really cheap price, I'll get them. So I got a playset exclusive Northern Nightmare. So it has gray rims and a gray driveline. This one I was super excited to get. Scarlet Bandit. This is the 2005 edition. Yeah, in 2007, they re-released it and called it the Special Edition. I'm not really sure what that meant, but it was the exact same thing as 2005, so I got this. Yet again, it's like the seller took it right out of the package. Such good condition. These two were replacement trucks. Bounty Hunter from MacBullock Max that he gave me. The axle I could not unbend. And then a Small Hub Maximum Destruction. This one was just in better condition than my other one. The other one will be going to Mega Monster 907A, along with the other Bounty Hunter, in case you're wondering. And the last truck from the older haul, T-Benz Small Hub. This one I was super excited to get for such a good price. And when it came in the mail, it was in such good condition. I was nervous the axles might be wobbly, but no. Even the two little hooks right there are still intact. That's really awesome. Really happy that guy had it for such a good price. All right, so now we'll just speed run through. Well, not really speed run, I have some time. So I'll go through most of the other trucks. I'll try and do mainly Small Hubs first. Might throw some Big Hubs in. But anyway, Mine Blower, this just came yesterday, and it actually does not roll if you don't put enough pressure on. So I think I just need to put some WD-40 in there. Just so that it's an old truck. Yeah, most of these trucks I got just because they're really good prices, really good steel. First ever metal-based Reptoid for me. Cool thing about the older Reptoids you may not know is that they actually added the third row of teeth. Oh, one truck I forgot to grab. Metal-based Iron Outlaw. I just replaced it with another one of mine. So yeah. Right, let me try and do Small Hubs. This one's a temporary one for now. Small Hub Jurassic Attack. It's missing the little back part there, and the tailgate has a lot of paint chips on it. So this is a temporary one. If you guys have one that's in really good condition and you don't mind selling it for a low price, please let me know. DM me on Instagram at smmjcollector16. And stick around to the end of the video. I will show the extra trucks that are for trade or sale. So yeah, here we go. Great Bite Small Hub. I have the Big Hub version. I just needed the Small Hub. Got this for just like $8. And yeah, it's in really good condition. So I said I have the Small Hub SUV Eradicator. I also got the pickup truck version. This one was wobbly a bit. You can tell in the front wheel it's wobbling. That's really okay. I mean, I'm not really going to use the Small Hubs that much. I don't want to break them, God forbid. Sergeant Smash. And actually, I did get the Big Hub version too, so I finished my Sergeant Smashes in this one lot. What's weird is that the Big Hub version does not have the tire, and that's not like a kid broke it off. If you go on Brian Z. Patton, in the package, Sergeant Smash does not have the other wheel. The Incredible Hulk, I was going to get this from Applebug back, but his was in really bad condition, and he was already giving me the Bounty Hunter and Tough Enough that had bent axles, so I'm like, I'll just wait to see if I can find one. And I did, this one's in really good condition, so I'm really happy to find that. King Crunch, this one isn't in the best. Massive paint chip on top. Still though, happy to get this. Pretty generic Small Hub. I think this is the last one. If not, you'll see another one later. This one I was really happy. The first generation, I like to call it, Gravedigger. So I have two out of the four of the WCW trucks, Gravedigger and Sting. Now I'll just move on to Big Hubs. Tropical Thunder, I have the 2013 edition, so I just needed the older version, and this was it. Let's see. Bounty Hunter. This is a weird version that I actually needed. I compared it to my other one. It's actually different. It has a bunch of Freestyle logos everywhere. Some of the tampos, I guess you could say, are placed differently. And the grill is actually painted black. So very interesting. I got two Predators, so just this normal one from like the 2008 era. This is just a normal one, no tilt off or anything. I know there is a metal base. And this is a weird one to track down because there's like metal base, there's a shocks, there's a tilt off. Very strange Predator. That'll be a bit tricky to track down. Not this one though. The Spectre Flames one. This is one of my most desired Spectre Flames of all time. I found it for $11. It was in the package, so I have the box right here. And I kept this because this is just cool. And I just moved the camera. So yeah, super happy to find this. This just has such a cool color to it. And I just love Spectre Flames in general. It's one of the best series they've ever had. All right, I'll do these two body styles. One thing I forgot to bring up here, I replaced my metal base Iron Outlaw. I don't know if I said that already, did I? I have no idea. Anyway, Pony Express. And Steel Striker, I got both of these old Spider-Man style bodies. Both of those trucks, really good condition. I'm trying to stick with the metal bases. Pouncer, my first ever Pouncer. Yet again, this is just the normal one. There is a metal base tilt-off and a plastic base tilt-off that I have to try and get. Here's a little plastic base, Iron Outlaw in red. I don't have that in plastic base at all. Let's see. All right, 2005 SUV trucks, got two of them. The Beast, and then Robots, was in a different lot. I actually should note that one of the lots I bought actually was 5150 Black Boxes. If you're on Instagram, you know who that is, but turns out one of these lots was his. I found out when I was leaving feedback. Oh, here's a Small Hub. Expelled, I think that's the last one. This body is a bit loose, but still, really cool body design, so. Plus, there's no Big Hub version or anything, so it's just one and done. Oh, there's another Small Hub. Hold on. So, Cadillac Arrest. This and Cutting Corners are my first two, like, Hearst design trucks. Super happy to get these two. Cadillac Arrest has a couple wobble axles. Cutting Corners is fine. Either way, though, both trucks are awesome. One of the best ever made. There's another Small Hub. Sudden Impact, I've always wanted this Small Hub, and I found it. Super happy. This came with Eradicator and Sergeant Smash Small Hub. Alright. Oops. Blew a couple trucks that are in, like, a series. Mud Tread Storm Damage. I passed that up plenty of times in 2013 because I wanted a normal version, and I wasn't collecting mud and stuff then. Spectre Flames El Matador. Super cool. My first ever El Matador. Yes, I'm behind on my collection. Shut up. Spectre Flames Illuminator. This one's cool. It has a few paint chips. This is another one from 5150 Black Box. Iron Warrior Shocks. I never knew this was a Shocks truck until I saw it in a lot. I'm like, you know what? Shocks are pretty hard to track down. Let me just get it. It's a good lot, too. It has some decent trucks. All right. Some more metal bases. Metal base Team Suzuki. I finished my Team Suzuki's because I got the metal base. And I got the plastic base right here. And I have that Easter Beast one. It's really beat up, so I want to hopefully find a replacement one day. Sticking with the metal bases, Livewire from 2004. First ever Livewire for me. There's also a red one that's normal and red one that's tilt-off. I should have put this in the Shocks version. Iron Warrior from 2004. I never knew this was from 2004. I thought it was like a 2007 truck. And I was really happy because I had the Ford grill. I love the old Ford grills. I want to get as many of those as I can. Here's a truck I passed up way too many times. M2D Camo Thunder. Got it in, yet again, one of the lots. This truck I got from Sabres, but it was beaten to hell. Full bore 2008. Super cool. Full bores aren't really my favorite. You know, I'll get them if I find them. Avenger 2005. I'm not sure. I don't know if that hood opens up there, but apparently the hood is the rarer variation. I never knew that existed. So yeah, I was really happy to find that. Pillage it. The seller was honest with me. They did note that it was missing a couple horns right there. That's okay. I like honesty. I'd rather not just get a broken truck. Hot Wheels Shocks. Got this in the package for $8, I think, or $10. I'm not sure. Stick with the metal bases. This is the last one, I believe. This one, I was really happy because it's actually El Toro Loco Tilt-Off's metal base. Very hard to come by the tilt-offs. I'm eyeing a couple on eBay right now I might buy. Yeah. Anyway. I'll just speed through some generic trucks. Aftershock with yellow rims. I just needed that version. My first ever Devastator. This plastic base. Crazy Train. I have the Spectre Flames. Just needed a normal one. Cyclops. Just didn't have it. Ended up being in a lot. This Gunslinger, I have the Mud Treads version of it. I just needed a normal one. I got a normal one at Savers, but it was broken with that full bore, actually, now that I mention it. My very first Spike. This is really cool because I didn't know that the drive line was black. It's a really cool touch. Let's see. Oh, I forgot about this. Instigator Spectre Flames. Super cool to get this one as well. Black Stallion. I think there's like the 2008 version. Anyway, just one of the basic older versions of it. I like this one. This is one of my favorite Black Stallions. The Broker. This one was a super cool find. I was really happy to find this one. Brokers are really hard to come by. 2009 Excalibur. Just needed it. My first normal Stone Crusher. I've been the New Tool Edgeglow for a while. Jurassic Attack in the bright blue. And this is actually the final truck. Yeah, I just needed a bright blue Jurassic Attack for once. And now, guys, I'll show you all the trucks that are for sale or trade. All right, so here are the trucks that are for sale or trade. American Guardian Small Hub. This is for if you want to make customs with it. Shock Therapy, Patriot. Wheels colored in. I'll try and clean that. Grinder, Bent Axle. Pure Adrenaline, Tropical Thunder, Metal Militia, Bars Leaks Eliminator, Annihilator. That's plastic base. Indicative Destruction, Max D. Nine-time Champion, Maximum Destruction. Captain's Curse, and Hot Wheels with plastic base. So, hey guys, that is the eBay haul. I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time.